She's the light of my world. My niece Madison, who at that time was 17 months old, began to choke on a piece of cheese. And we all didn't realize she was choking. I thought, honestly, it'd go, it'd slide down her throat or she'd cough it back up, but it didn't. Her eyes got bigger, my brother's eyes got bigger. And I was like, oh my goodness, she's choking. So I calmed down enough to pick her up off my lap and stand her up in the chair and wrap my arms around the chair and her. And because she was 17 months old, I didn't want to hurt her. So I gave her two quick abdominal thrusts and the cheese had came out along with everything else. But, and after that, she took off running. She's 17, she's exploring at this age. So she took off and it didn't hit me what I had done until about 10, 15 minutes later when she came running around the corner and she gave me a big hug. She's a little light, you know, she brings a lot of joy, and to know that within split seconds I could have lost all that, I saved her life. She's alive because of the skills that the American Red Cross taught me.
We're going to go car shopping. We're gone probably about 25 to 30 minutes, and I got a phone call from my daughter, "Mom, where are you at?" And I told her outside of Neoga, and she told me that we needed to turn around and come home. The house was on fire. The sky was just black. And when we got to our street, we went as close up to the fire line as we could. And I told Ken, "Stay in the car with the boys. I've got to go see what's going on." Firefighters were in the process of putting out the house fire. Front windows were blown out. Fire and smoke was just billowing out the house. We had left the house with four dogs and two cats in the house. And my neighbor Tina came up and said that she got three of the dogs out, and they're service dogs. And they were in her backyard, literally chewing the wood fence to get back home. We lost a beagle and two kittens in the house fire, along with everything else. It was a total loss, including our vehicle. My daughter was on the cell phone. I didn't know at the time who she was talking to. And come to find out, it was the Red Cross. And probably within just a very short time, I don't even know the time span, here came the Red Cross. They gave the boys stuffed animals, their little Red Cross stuffed bears. And they gave us blankets and little emergency kits, toothbrush, toothpaste, soap, washcloth, coloring books. And they got the boys a nebulizer and more albuterol. They got a shelter. We had a roof over our head at a motel for a week as our landlord got another house fixed up for us. The boys have their blankets on their beds. And Lord forbid, I try and wash them. They didn't give me a bill. I didn't get a bill for the motel, for the medication, nothing. They were just there. Practice makes perfect, and the Red Cross was right there doing it perfectly.